Welcome students, today we start our new chapter continuity and differentiability. It is very first topic of calculus. Five chapters in calculus from chapter 5 to chapter 9. Continuity and differentiability, application of derivatives, integration, application of integration and differential equation. All five chapters are interconnected. As without continuity, we can't understand differentiation. Without derivatives, we can't do integration. And without integration, we can't do application of integration. So now we start continuity. Our today's topic is continuity. In class 11th, we discussed limits and derivatives. So I suggest you to revise that chapter for better understanding. Let us take a function fx is equal to 1 if x less than equal to 1 and fx is equal to 2 if x greater than 1. Students, we draw graph of this function. This is the graph of this function. As we see, at x less than equal to 1, fx is equal to 1, and x greater than 1, fx is equal to 2. So if I ask you, can you draw graph of this function without lifting the pen or pencil, you will say no. So generally, if graph of a function cannot be drawn without lifting pen or pencil, then it is not continuous. Mathematically, we say as x tends to 1 from left side means left hand limit, and as x tends to 1 from right side, it means right hand limit. Here, left hand limit is 1 and right hand limit is 2. So, left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, and we say function is not continuous. But if left hand limit equal to right hand limit, then what can we say about the function? We take one more example. Let fx is equal to 1 if x not equal to 1 and 2 if x equal to 1. Now again, draw the graph of this function. This is the graph of this function. Again, I ask you, can you draw the graph without lifting the pen? You say no. So fx is not continuous, as we cannot draw graph without lifting the pen. But here, as x tends to 1 from left side, then fx is equal to 1. And as x tends to 1 from right side, fx is equal to 1. But at x is equal to 1, fx equal to 2. So we can say for continuity of a function, left hand limit must be equal to right hand limit, and it should be equal to value of fx at that point. Now we come to definition. A function is continuous at some point c in its domain if limit x tends to c negative fx equal to limit x tends to c positive fx equal to fc. Left hand limit equal to right hand limit equal to fc. But function fails to be continuous at x is equal to c if function is not defined at x equal to c, means fc does not exist. Number two, either left hand limit or right hand limit does not exist, or both exist but left hand limit not equal to right hand limit. Number three, limit x tends to c fx exist, but limit x tends to c f of x is not equal to f of c. Number fourth, left hand limit equal to right hand limit not equal to f of c. It is also known as removable discontinuity, and this type of discontinuity can be removed by redefining the function. Dear students, some functions are continuous, so please note down. A constant function is everywhere continuous. Number two, a polynomial function is everywhere continuous. Number three, exponential function is everywhere continuous. Number four, modulus function is everywhere continuous. Number five, irrational function is continuous in its domain. Number six, a trigonometric function are continuous in their domain. And number seven, logarithmic function is continuous on open interval 0 to infinity. So students, please revise all these basics about continuity and revise chapter limits of class 11th. This is all for today. Thank you.